Hi, this is Dr. David Cathcart. I'm from Heartland Regional Medical Center in St. Joseph, Missouri. There is some exciting new technology out there in cancer treatment, and it's called nanotechnology. And nanotechnology was developed in the 1980s and was originally designed with the idea in mind that we could build very small machines, if you will, of molecules that do work for us. They may build other types of molecules. Technically speaking, nanotechnology or nano instruments will take an atom of one cell and put it in a specific place of another cell and build these molecules step by step till they get bigger and bigger. Well, there's a very interesting application for nanotechnology with respect to medicine, and particularly in the treatment of cancer, and that is called the Trojan horse concept. These nanomolecules are extremely small. They range in the order of 1 nanometer to maybe as much as 1,000 nanometers. Now, just to give you a comparison of what that is, a nanometer is 1/1,000,000,000 of a meter. A meter is a little larger than a yard. So 1/1,000,000,000 of a meter is a nanometer. To give an idea in reality so we can get our hands around that, a nanometer to a meter would be the same as comparing a marble to the earth, the size of the earth. So these nano instruments or nanomolecules are very, very small. Now, the Trojan horse concept is pretty cool. One example is something called a dendromere. And these dendromere molecules, very small, have multiple arms on them. And we can attach food on one of the arms, such as folic acid, which is a nutrient for a cancer cell, and a cancer-killing agent, such as methotrexate, on another arm, while the cancer cell is fooled into thinking, here's food source. So it accepts the nanomolecule, the Trojan horse, into its walls, thinking that it's food, only to find out when it's too late that methotrexate has been unleashed inside the cancer cell, killing it. These nanomolecules are so small, they can go in and out of the pores of these cells. They're very many, many, many times smaller than most cells. They can go in and out of the pores of blood vessels. So while nanotechnology is exciting, it's still in the experimental stage, and it'll probably be a few more years before we see it in mainstream treatment of medicine. But the cool thing about nanotechnology, particularly in the treatment of cancer, is it'll help us to avoid many of the side effects that are so dangerous. The side effects of hair loss, the side effects of nausea, the side effects of losing hearing. All these things are very common to normal chemotherapy agents nowadays. Nanotechnology holds promise to help avoid some of those side effects while vastly improving our ability to treat and cure cancer. This is Dr. David Cathcart. Thanks for letting me talk to you about nanotechnology.